Now, I've shown this very often to show how we cannot connect those legato lines, that they're supposed to sound connected, but physically what they show is the substitution right there, which twists and turns, and you're not going to get a legato line anyway, but you can connect it through the inner voice with tone and with shaping. Tone and shaping is so powerful that you can go from here to there and to another note, but if you continue to the other hand, but if you continue the line through the shaping and through matching sounds, the continuation of sound, you will still get a line that sounds legato, whether it's connected or not. So we have this also. This is your downbeat, so it goes here. It's not, which often it's played, and then people usually play it like that. But it's a misplacement of the beats, because the downbeat, which is the strongest one, comes, he resolves to here. Now, he plays around with us, and that beginning is very, very difficult. That's one of the reasons that it's difficult. It gives you an eighth note on the third beat. So the question is, how do we continue music over rests, which is one of the central issues? How do we keep long lines sounding long? Because if you stop it, which often is how it sounds, sounds familiar, but that's not, you know, that again, how do we keep music moving? This is the whole issue this week, that the beat and the correct treatment of rhythm is one of the ways in which we do it, but of course the central issues here are tone, are shaping, some pedaling, of course,